Hello children, welcome to the second video. Now when I was asking you questions, right? So I have one more question to ask. Okay, now let me ask you one proverb, okay, very shortly, and you tell me what does it mean. Okay, don't count your chickens until they are hatched. This is a proverb. Okay. Don't count your chickens until they are hatched. What does it mean? Can you tell me the meaning of it? Think. Think and tell me. Okay. Okay. Let me help you with some sentences and you will understand. Suppose I'm working. I get my salary and I will get to, I'm thinking, I will buy a car when I get my bonus this year. And I'm making plans like what car to buy and which one to buy and all that stuff. Okay. So, I'm already making plans to buy a car when I get my bonus. So, here, this proverb fits right. Don't count your chickens until they are hatched. Means, what? What will you say? Think about it and tell me the meaning. Okay. Now children, this proverbs what I'm explaining, you need to write them down in your book. And the way I'm explaining to you, you need to also understand. Write some explanations so that you can understand, right? Because in the exams, when I'm giving you proverbs, you need to write the meaning of the proverb, right? And make a sentence by yourself. You should know how to make a sentence by yourself, right? Okay, let's take another proverb. The grass is green on the other side of the fence. What do you mean by that? The grass is green on the other side of the fence. Let me write it for you. The grass is green on the other side of the fence. What does it mean, the grass is green on the other side of the fence? It means that what we see in the other person's house or other person, it looks always nice, right? For example, if we look at our neighbors and we think, oh, look at our neighbors, they are having such a big house, they are so rich, they spend so much of money, they have a car. And then we try to compare ourselves with them, which is very, very wrong. We should not compare ourselves with anybody. We have to improve ourselves at every passing day. But we should not compare ourselves and, you know, probably they have some difficulty, they have some hardship. No problem if they have a big house, probably they have some problems, we don't know. They might not even tell us what are the problems, but for sure, they might be having some difficulties, some problems which nobody knows about, right? So, it is not fair to look at other people and compare ourselves. We should be happy in whatever we have, right? We should not look at other people and, you know, have negative feelings about ourselves. No, we should be happy and we should be grateful. And only when we learn to be grateful, we will be happy, right? So, we should always be self-satisfactory and happy that whatever God gave us, we should be grateful. Okay, now these are some examples what I have given. Let us do one more example. Now, in between, before we do something, I want to ask you one question. What are proverbs? I told you, right? What are proverbs? Proverbs are short sentences which give us advice, which give us warning, which generally contain wisdom words, right? So my question is, what are proverbs? Question number one. Okay. Question number two. What do proverbs usually tell us? Or what does proverbs usually what are proverbs? The second question is, why do we use proverbs? Okay, why do we use proverbs? There has to be a reason, right? We simply do not start talking the proverbs, right? So why do we, like, for example, actions speak louder than words, right? But when, suppose you and your friend are talking and your friend told you that he is going to give you a storybook, okay, but then your friend tells you, you ask your friend, when are you going to bring me the storybook to read? So your friend says, I'm going to bring it next Friday. Right? I'm going to bring you next Friday. But then you say, oh, that's what you said last Friday. That's what you said last Friday, right? So action speaks louder than words. That means your friend is not fulfilling his promise. It's empty words, empty promises. If he would have fulfilled his promise, he would have got you the book. So he did not bring you the book, right? So actions speak louder than words. That means those were fake promises, false promises, right? So that was the second question. Now, children, you have to do exercise 4, right? Exercise 4, which is rearrange the sentences to make complete sense. Okay, rearrange the sentences to make complete sense. There are a few sentences here. Okay, few sentences. For example, E. Let me give you one or two, right? E. Check E. Push, tell him, stop to around beating the. So how will you rearrange? Let me help you with one. Okay, so Bush, tell him, stop to around beating the. So after rearranging, how does it come? Tell him to stop beating around the bush. Tell him to stop beating around the bush. What does it mean? Means you are asking him, what is your name? And he is telling you, no, I went there and then I had one ice cream and after that I went home and... So you are telling him, oh, I don't want to listen to stories. Come to the point. What is your name? So that is the meaning. Tell him to stop. So we are telling that person who we need some information from, right? Tell him to stop beating around the bush. Means don't give me all those stories. Come straight to the point. Okay, that is the meaning of that. Okay, check F. Let's help you with one more. Never better late than. What does it mean? Better late than never. So at least now, suppose your time when you wake up is 6:30, but now today it's already 7 o'clock, and then you think, my God, now it's already 7 o'clock and I will reach late to school. Then you think, it's better, I don't want to go to school today. I will miss the school today. I don't want to go to school. I will skip school today. But then when your mother comes in and says, oh, what's wrong? Why are you not getting dressed up? Why are you still sitting on the chair? What is happening? So you say, no, I don't want to go to school. It's already late. So what does the mother tell you? Your mother says, better late than never. You get ready, go to school. At least you will reach 15 minutes late. But still you will not miss the entire day's lesson. Because if you miss the entire day, you have to copy all the 8 subjects, which is a task again, right? You have to get somebody's book, you have to copy. It's hard time, right? So better you will only reach 15 minutes late. You we will tell your teacher about it and just apologize. Say sorry that you are late. But if you miss the school, the entire day is gone. You will miss all your school, all your classes, all your explanation, everything, right? So better late than never. That is the meaning of it. So here you have a few of them. So two of that I told you, right? So 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 is yours to do as homework. You have to rearrange that and then I will ask you in Google Meet. You have to tell me what it means. Right, children? Thank you.